Very grateful to Mark as well, as you can see, he's very supportive, and without him, you know, this wouldn't be possible. So, thank you very much. So, if you could, now I've got the pleasure to introduce Karen. She's a great lady. She's I've met Karen perhaps a few months ago, and since then we've met a couple of times, and I've learned so much about her story, which is quite unbelievable. Coming from an accident, from your previous businesses as well. So I'm looking forward to listening to Karen, and I'm sure we all come to learn so much from Karen. So, welcome, Karen.
My name is Karen Newton, and I'm an author, I'm a speaker, and I'm the founder of the £2.73 Club. But my journey started a long time ago in New Zealand. I'd always been fascinated with numbers and money. I'd always wanted to be rich, but I didn't quite know how to do it. And one day, I'm driving home from work, I've just turned onto a road, you know New Zealand, they have these really long, straight roads that just go out into the country. And I'm driving along, and suddenly I've got this splash of white in front of me. I wake up in hospital 3 days later, and there's a policeman stood at the foot of my bed. And he said to me, I've been in a car crash. And from the information he'd been able to put together, a vehicle had come speeding through a stop sign. I'd hit the front wing, my car spun around, I hit the back wing, went into a somersault, and the car I was driving was upside down on the other side of the road when the car traveling around me went into the back of it. After 3 months of surgery, doctor said I wasn't going to walk again. I wouldn't move this arm, and the brain trauma had caused memory problems, speech problems, and my eyesight as well. I need glasses. Well, they sent me home in a wheelchair, and they said, that's it, can't do anything more for you. When I got home, I thought, there's going to be something else that I can do. So I got the Yellow Pages out. We didn't have internet in those things, it was a little bit before the time of internet. And I just went through the Yellow Pages, and I found a heap of people that were able to help me. And the first was John, who was a doctor, and he broke the bones, he reset them, he tore the ligaments, he basically rebuilt the body. I did say supermodel body, I'd like, grateful for what you get. Then there was Glenda, who was a physio, and after 3 months in the hospital, muscle wasted, was really bad. So she started working with me to rebuild muscles. Alan was a Feldenkrais practitioner, and I'm not sure if you've heard of Feldenkrais. It really trains the brain to move muscles that compensate for the ones that can't work. So wherever you lost the use of the muscle down the inside of the spine, touch it when it collapses. Through Feldenkrais, I learned to use the arch in my foot to lock my leg into position that allows them to stand. So it's unusual to see me in shoes. I'm usually trainers with arch supports in them. And then there was my husband. And what my husband did was I needed to be able to exercise, but I couldn't use gym equipment. So he built equipment out of really light metals, bands, pulleys, anything he could find. And between the four of them, we put this plan together, and it involved my doing an exercise 5 minutes every hour. And that was every hour that I was awake. Now, I'm an early riser. I'm up at 4:30 in the morning. I go to bed at 10 at night. So for 5 minutes every hour, I did an exercise that helped me to learn to walk. And it took me 2 years to get back on my feet. It took me a year to get back on my feet, but I was fantastic on the flat. But give me a slope, I couldn't cope with it, and I couldn't get up down steps. And we put the plan back in place again, altered it slightly, and that involved me stepping on and off a sheet of paper for 5 minutes steps every hour for months just to get the brain working to do the steps. But during that time, I had 55 minutes and an hour when I couldn't do anything. I was just on a bed, waiting to be moved, ready to do my next 5 minutes of exercise. And that was when I discovered there were people out there writing books about how to make money. And it was something I'd always wanted to do. So I started reading. And I read and read. It took me 2 years to learn to walk again. It took me 5 years to get back on a tennis court and 7 years to get back on skis. I then started putting into practice everything I had learned from an investment point of view. I was able then to concentrate on it. I borrowed £300 on a credit card and within 4 years turned it into £10 million. And as a result of that, I started writing books. My books sell all around the world and I've spoken in several countries then. I decided that I've achieved what I wanted to achieve. And it was so simple to do what I'd always wanted to do, and that was be rich. I just had never been given the knowledge. I didn't have the knowledge to be able to do it. And so I put together the £2.73 Club. And people say to me, why £2.73? Well, £2.73, if you save today, you've got £1,000 at the end of the year. If you invest your money at 14%, within 37 years you're a millionaire. If you don't invest any more at the age of 37, you get to 60, you are worth 23 million. And it's all about using the compounding effect. So what I teach the skills now is not to wait 37 years or 60 years to make the money. Is to bring it down and use the compounding effect. I call it SAC, which is synergy and accelerated compounding. And I bring it into a very small time frame. So students that work with me do this within 5 years. They make $1 million or $2 million within 5 years. They are then able to do whatever they want to do because they've also got the income that goes with it. So the 2073 Club is, I don't recommend products, I teach people the skills. And once they've got the skills, I support them while they get started, and then they're off and running on their own. I've got to the stage where I'm now able to give back to the community. And I am chair of talking about it to you. I'm chair of an association, a community project which is called Talk by Effect. And what the Effect project does is it's a Welsh Assembly funded project where we have a facilitator, the money just pays for the wage. And she works with anybody within the Talk by community who wants to start a business. Or if they've got a business established, they want to expand it. And she has below her what we call our resource team. And what the resource team does is it's anybody within the Torvine community that has a business. They come into the resource team, and when Jane, who's our facilitator, needs information to help the client move forward, she puts it out to the question out to the resource team. If we don't have anyone within the resource team who can support them, we ask them to tap into their networks of people that they know to bring in the expertise. So a business we're working with at the moment has clothing manufactured in China. They needed contacts in China. Through our resource team, we found people who were able to give them the contacts in China, so they can do their clothing line. Now, these people are all sportsmen and they are rugby players. You can imagine how tall rugby players are these days and how big. And traditional sports clothing doesn't fit. So you see some of them, I don't know if you've noticed, I've taken a lot more note now when I've been watching the rugby. The shirts sort of come here and you see them pulling the shirts down when they're playing. So these guys have developed a clothing line which is aimed at the rugby players. Then through my support network, I have a friend who works with the Welsh rugby team. And so she's been able to, they have a list of possible suppliers and the players who are those suppliers. And if they want to endorse any products, they can. So this group that I work with, they have been able to get access there to get their products endorsed by celebrities. And that's how they move their business forward. But then we've got smaller businesses that are just a one-man band and all they want is a room, sort of like this setup, where they can meet someone without running from their home. And so we have some members on board who make offices available for them to hold their meetings in a professional environment. So the Torvine Effect project has so far helped over 600 people start businesses within 3 years. Now, the Welsh Assembly withdrew funding to Business Wales and reduced the Business Wales funding. And where Business Wales used to be able to help small businesses starting, their focus is now on growth of existing businesses. So we're finding that we're extra busy now from that, attracting more people in to support through the Torvine Effect. So that's basically what I do. I rant, I speak, I bore people stuff about money.
Right, because I have my own business, I'm not, you know, I'm, I would say that most of the time I've always done it all by myself, or like my, I never really sought that much outside advice. You know, like, but before, when I was in Wales, I actually started a Subway franchise, and actually the Business Wales that they actually gave me a mentor, and that was like an amazing sort of like start, and it really helped, because they say that 90% of business.
I have a very good success rate. I'm not sure the actual figures, but as far as I'm aware, the businesses that we've supported, we've only had a couple that have struggled, but we've been able to sell those on to other members who were thinking of doing it, and they've been able to turn the business around and you know, accelerate their business. So it's really, it's just bringing a community together to support one another. And it's working really well. I do like the challenge of starting a new business. And I have a new venture that's starting in January, which is going through the planning stages at the moment. So I was quite interested when Mark was talking about television, because my new venture, I've got some partners and we're doing media presentation, storytelling and speech craft presentation skills. So we're, you know, it's quite interesting, maybe there's a use for some of the facilities here. But I find the challenge I'm getting through the 2.73 Club, because I'm supporting other people who are building businesses, they're building their investments, and they challenge me because they come back with questions, and if I don't know it, I've got to find the expert who does know how to answer that. So it keeps me going. But I've been in business for 26 years, and every day there's a challenge, one thing or